Hi, my name is Remigiusz Synowiec. This is our new Rogue 230IP AC-DC. The machine is capable of welding with TIG-AC, TIG-DC and MMA. And I guess you will be the most interested by welding with TIG-AC. And I will show you now how to set it up, what are the parameters and what we can do with TIG-AC. What you can see here is the full set of the machine and the accessories that you will find in the water-cooled Rogue AC-DC kit. The AC-DC main unit, the brand new Cool Mini coolant circulator, the brand new Exeor water-cooled torch, the work lead and the gas hose. Coming now to the one of most exciting new features of a Rogue AC-DC, you can see now the 5-inch full-color TFT screen with very intuitive user interface. So if you would like to set up your AC TIG parameters, you can use our wizard that is built into menu. The menu button, you would like to choose the process. We want to use the AC TIG with the HF ignition. Then we can choose between 1.6, 2.4 and 3.2 millimeters of the electrode. Then we will choose between green, gold or blue and gray electrode type. And now we are ready to weld with 2.4 gold electrode. The wizard that I have just shown you was easy and fast. And this is just a basic setting. If you want to set up more, we can use the additional menu. The AC settings in the Rogue AC-DC are pretty extensive. First, the most obvious is the welding amperage. So we can go up to even 230 amps. Then we have the offset and the balance. Then there is the possibility to choose the wave shape. There are four wave shapes implemented into Rogue AC-DC. The first one is the square wave. The square wave gives you a harsh noise, but the arc will be the most stable of all of those ones. The next one will be the soft square. Soft square is the combination of square and sine wave. The paddle will be more fluid, but the arc will still be very stable. The third one will be the sine wave. The sine wave is the most traditional wave shape implemented in the AC machines. It will give you shorter peak time so that you can weld some thinner materials. The fourth wave shape is the triangle. The triangle gives you the opportunity to weld the thinnest materials due to shortest peak current time. Now, as we decided which wave shape will be used for our application, we can still customize it. Now, we need to choose the offset and the balance. Both of those parameters give you the opportunity to work with electrode positive and electrode negative. More electrode positive will give you better cleaning action. More electrode negative will give you better penetration for the material. Once we set up the offset and the balance, we can now try to change the frequency of the wave shape. The frequency of the wave shape is the speed, how fast you will switch from electrode positive to electrode negative. This will affect the focus of the arc. The higher the frequency, the arc will be more focused. Now, as we have discussed all of the wave shapes and the wave shapes parameters, I can show you how you can easily put it into your home screen. We can go into the settings, choose the TIG home view and set up AC settings. Now when we come back to the home screen, you can see your wave shape and your wave shapes parameters. And if you click on a knob, you will go directly into the AC settings menu. The next feature I would like to show you is the sequencer. The sequencer will allow you to adjust all of the parameters of the whole welding cycle. We start with the gas preflow, Then we go to the start current, slope up, the main current, slope down, final current, and the gas pulse flow. If you want to have your sequencer right under your hand, you will just get into the settings, take home view, and change it to the sequencer. Now you can see the sequencer on your home screen. If you want to save your welding job, all you need to do is to find the job slot, click the knob for 2 seconds, and you have just saved your welding job. There are 10 slots in here to save your welding parameters. And first 3 of them can be recalled using our torch. If you want to use this feature, you need to go to the settings menu, and switch the toggle of trigger job shift. You can see now on the top of the screen that the trigger job shift is activated. I will show you how it works. If you take your torch and click it once, you will see the first job has been activated. Click it twice, job number 2 is being activated. Now I would like to tell you something about the pulse parameters. First one is the frequency. The frequency will allow you to control the weld width and the heat input. Then we have the peak current. The peak current allows you to control the penetration. Then we have the peak time, which would be the ratio between peak current and the background current. And the background current, being the lower level current, will allow you not to overheat your material. Pulse feature is available both for AC and DC TIG welding, and it can be adjusted from 0.5 to 200 Hz. Now you can see on the screen all the trigger modes. The first one is the standard 2-stroke. Then we have the 4-stroke and 2 special trigger modes. The first is the 4-stroke dual current, which will allow you to change the welding current during welding without extinguishing the arc. And the last one is the spot welding, which is helpful welding thin materials for tack welding and to get some consistent welds. The new Rogue AC-DC can do both TIG AC and TIG DC. Rogue AC-DC features all of the functions that we already have in the Rogue ES and Rogue ET family. You can choose the TIG DC welding either with HF start or the lift arc start. And DC will be used mostly for stainless steel welding and mild steel welding. You can choose as well the stick electrode. And as you can see here in the menu, you can choose between rutile and basic type and the cellulosic type. Once you have chose your electrode type, you can also adjust the hot start, which will influence the arc starting, and the arc force, which will influence the arc stability. Here's what you can find in the information pages. First are the wedges and spurs for your XOR torches. Then you have some tips and hints regarding the wave shapes and wave shapes parameters. Then the recommended filler metals, some general maintenance activities, and a QR code to the user manual. The really cool tips and hints are here. You can just take a look at all of the wave shapes and see how they look and how you can use it. Also, you can take a look at the wave shapes parameters. So we go into the offset and you see how it will influence the weld. Same with the balance. And the influence of the frequency for the weld. We want Rogue to be easy to operate for welders all over the world. And that's why we have prepared the 29 languages in our user interface. Whether you are the beginner or the seasoned pro, the Rogue ACDC will allow you to produce perfect welds without any complication.